come today, I thought I'd just put a short practice, just focusing on core. So core is such an important part of our day-to-day lives, really supporting us, supporting our back, and just helping us move around. So I just thought it would be a chance to just spend a little bit of time. I do have a longer practice on core as well in one of the 16-minute videos, but I'm going to try and keep it quite short today just to really focus on the core. So do get ready and join me in a nice comfortable seated position, whichever seated position is good for you, with a nice tall long spine, nice relaxed shoulders, and let's just gently close our eyes and just start by bringing our awareness to our body, to our breath, as we bring ourselves to our practice. Just take a few moments before we begin, just to tune in. So just starting to slow down the breath, relaxing the body, just letting go of the day's thoughts, letting go of the tension. Just starting to notice what our body feels like, what it's telling us today. If there's any little niggly bits of tension, just letting it go, just relaxing the body. Let's take three more deep breaths in through the nose, out through the mouth. In through the nose, final time, and a nice big sigh. Good, and let's get ready to begin as we bring our hands together in front of our heart. Give our palms a nice brisk rub, starting to bring warmth and energy to those palms, to the body. And then placing those palms over our eyes as we blink back into the light and taking our hands away, we begin with our greeting of love and peace. Namaste. Thank you for being here. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, if you do, that'll just give you a little notification when I do post new classes on. So do feel free to do that. So let's uncross, recross our legs for a moment and just loosen up. So take nice big shoulder rolls. Exaggerating that movement, and then in the opposite direction, just loosening up. Good, and then let's come back to center onto our hands and knees into tabletop cat cow. Bring those wrists under shoulders, knees underneath hips as we inhale. Tilt the tailbone up, draw the shoulders down the back, gazing up towards the ceiling. And then as you exhale, rounding up the spine, tuck the tailbone under, chin to the chest. Let's do that a few more times, opening up, rooting down through those fingers as we take a big breath in. Exhaling, rounding up. Maybe tuck the toes and give them a little stretch. And let's continue with the movement with the feet, with the spine. Nice big breaths in your own time, connecting to your breath. Notice how your body's feeling. And let's take our final round with a nice big inhale. As we open up the chest, exhale, rounding up. Squeeze out that breath. And then coming back to our normal breath as we come to a neutral spine. And we're going to start firing up that core. So really rooting through those fingers, especially down through the knuckles, so you're not collapsing into your wrists. Tuck the toes under and just taking the knees slightly off the mat. Elbows are turning to either side. Just feel that connection through the core. Start drawing up through your pelvic floor, drawing in through your navel. And then release. Start straightening the legs. Still keeping the knees soft. Take a nice big stretch through those arms, through that spine as we tilt the tailbone up towards the ceiling. And then whilst you're here, maybe just creating a bit of movement, just loosening up. And shaking out the neck, the head. Maybe walking the legs one at a time, bending and straightening, taking a side stretch. So whatever feels good for you. So get ready to begin, coming back to center. Let's take that right heel up towards the ceiling. Nice big stretch as we let the left heel go down to the mat. And then bring that right knee, starting to bend as we shift the weight forward. Just hover it behind that right elbow. Start drawing in through the core. And then take a big step with the right foot or a couple of steps. Bring that left knee down. The left hand stays next to the right foot. Take the right hand up towards the ceiling. And then take the right hand, placing it behind your back. And keep rotating that shoulder around. Just opening up the chest towards the ceiling. And then release. Come back to center. Hand on either side. Stepping back down dog. Getting ready for the left side. Left heel reaches up towards the ceiling. Right heel down, root down through those hands. Bend that left knee, shift the weight forward. Knee comes to hover behind the left elbow. Energizing right knee away. You can always bring it down to the mat if you need to. And then take a big step through with that left foot. As the right knee comes down, right hand to the side of the left foot, left hand up. Reaching up and then placing it behind the back as we keep rotating, top shoulder back, opening up that chest, and then gazing down as we come through into a forward bend. And let's come into a halfway lift, hands to the shins, lengthen the spine, and then soften the knees, use those shoulders, a nice big circle with the arms as we come back to the heart. And we'll get ready to start. So as we root down in Tadasana, rooting down through our feet, opening up the chest, let's take a nice big circle back into a gentle back bend, and we come through into a forward bend. Let's take our right foot back, knees on the mat, chest up, chin up, stepping down dog. And let's come forward, bring the knees down, touch down with chest and chin. Slide the legs back as we lift the chest into a baby cobra. Tuck the toes under, we're back to down dog. Stepping that right foot through between the hands, left knee comes down. Lifting up the chest, gazing ahead into a forward bend. Let's start coming up, roll the shoulders, hands come back to the heart. And let's finish the salutation on the left side, reaching back into a forward bend. Let's take that left leg back, knees on the mat. If you want to make it a little bit more dynamic, you can have that knee off the mat. Checking bent knees stacked over ankle, into down dog. Shifting that weight forward as the knees come down, bending elbows, chest and chin, slide the legs back, lifting the chest into a baby or full cobra. Tuck the toes under, back to down dog. A nice big step through with that left foot, bring the right knee down, lifting up the chest into a forward bend. Good. Start rolling those shoulders, rooting down through those feet as the hands come back to the heart. And let's come into chair with our feet hip distance apart. We're going to start getting that core engaged and starting to focus more on the core. So like this is a little box, we're going to draw up through the pelvic floor. Draw through the sides, transverse abdominals, as we draw the navel back and just pushing down from the bottom of the diaphragm, just coming into a little box, locking it, keep that energy and bend those knees, bring the arms in front, have those wrists just slightly higher than the shoulders. Get that weight going back, lifting up the toes, lifting up through that pelvic floor, drawing that navel in. As we inhale, let's start straightening the legs and see if we can come up onto our toes, lift those heels, lengthen the arms back, and then let's go back down. Heels come down, back into chair, lifting the toes, get that weight going back, lifting up through the pelvic floor, draw that navel in. Two more times, nice big breath as we reaching up, strengthening those ankles. Exhale, drawing through that core, coming into chair, lifting up the toes. Final time, reaching up, into chair, shifting back, reaching further if you want, challenging yourselves, let the tailbone go a little bit lower, and then into a forward bend, hanging here for a moment. Bring the hands to the shins, lengthen the spine, and then softening the knees, closing in a little bit more. Get those hands close to the mat, and we're going to take a nice big step back into down dog. So stepping back, down dog, root down through those hands. We're going to shift into a high plank, energizing those heels back, following out through the top of the body, really pressing through those fingers, rooting up through that navel. You can bring your knees down if you need to have some assistance, but still keeping them slightly far back so they're not right under your hips, just to get that core activation. We're going to go to a side plank. So either with the right knee on the mat as we're going to go to the right side, or just come straight to the outside of that right foot. Taking left hand up, oops, and just lining yourselves up. Oh dear. Keep drawing in through that navel. Nice long spine. Nice and steady through that right arm, rooting down through those fingers, reaching up with that top arm. And then release. Bring the arm back down into a high plank. Shift into down dog, releasing the pressure on that right wrist. And then shifting forward again. Bring the knees down, and we're going to scoop the chest straight through into a baby cobra, holding it here. If you can, release your hands and stretch them behind. If that's too much, just continue supporting with your hands underneath your shoulders. Keep reaching back, pressing the pelvis into the floor, and bring the hands back underneath shoulders. Tuck the toes under, back to down dog. And let's continue to the left side. So shift the weight forward again. Energizing those elbows back, hollowing out the top of the body. Draw through that navel, through that pelvic floor. And we're going to shift to the left side. Again, use that left knee and then inside of the right foot. We'll come onto the outside of the left foot, then the right foot as we take the right arm up. Again, keep drawing in through the navel. Maybe you can take the leg out. Play around a bit. Keep one shoulder stacked above the other. Keep drawing in through that core. And release. Come back to center. To a high plank. Back to down dog. And then take a moment in child's pose. Bring the knees down and relax those wrists, those arms, and take a break. And we'll get ready to continue in a moment, just bringing your breath back if you need to. And then coming back, hands come up in front of us, back into table. Take those knees hip distance apart, and just a few wrist stretches. So taking the fingers, pointing them side and then back. And then the opposite hand, having those fingers pointing back towards you, give your wrist a little stretch. If fingers are pointing directly back, you can always take a little movement backwards and forwards or side to side. But if you find your fingers are still pointing out to the sides, then do just hold there, let those wrists release, and not put any added pressure with movement. A few long breaths. And then we're going to release, so turn those fingers forward. And this time, let's flip the wrists over. So back of the hand comes down on the mat. And just a gentle pressure to give the wrist a stretch again. Try not to overdo it. And release. Opposite hand. Again, giving that a little stretch. Good. Release the hand onto the floor. We're going to come back and sit down on the mat as we come into boat pose. So getting ourselves ready on the tips of our sit bones, nice and tall through the spine. Stop drawing that navel in and just leaning back slightly, keeping the chest opened, the knees soft, the neck soft. On the tips of our toes, hands either side or behind the legs. So you can go straight into boat pose if you have that in your practice. If you're getting used to boat pose, maybe stay with your toes supporting you. You're still getting that activation in the core, or you could start lifting your feet up or further straightening your legs more, depending on your hamstrings and your back. And just be mindful and keep slightly bent knees if you do have any lower back issues. Keep drawing the shoulders back so they stay nice and neutral. And the neck stays relaxed. Just take a few breaths here. Keep drawing yourself towards your thighs, thighs towards you. And keep drawing in through that navel. You want to start getting a nice little shape. Really getting into that deep energy, those deep core muscles. A little smile, lifting up the corners of our lips. And then release. And just relax the belly for a moment. And we'll get ready to do another round in your own time. When you're ready, just coming back, shifting onto those sit bones again. Going straight into the pose or just taking your time. Draw the shoulders back. Draw the navel in, keeping that lower back nice and protected. And just reminding your core, those muscles, that you are here. They are there to support you. Just take a few more breaths. Nice long breaths. Keep drawing in. Get those transverse abdominals. Just like little hands, they're supporting you. Two more breaths. Final breath. And then release. Good. Coming back to seated. Let go of any tension in the belly. Nice long spine. Let's take a little twist. Right hand goes to the left knee as the left hand goes behind. And not a big twist. Just nice and relaxed just to release any pressure. And come back to center and just switching sides. Good. Let's release. Come back to center onto our hands and knees again. We'll do one round of cat-cow before we move on. So wrists lined up, knees lined up, inhaling, gazing up towards the ceiling. And then exhaling, tucking tailbone under, chin to the chest. And then coming back to a neutral spine as we come into spinal balance. So we'll start off with our leg again, a good one again to get that core nice and stable. Take a big breath in. And then as you exhale and draw the navel in, up through the pelvis, take that right leg back. A nice flex with that right foot as we press that heel away, energizing that leg, but still keeping it drawn into its hip socket. Make sure the leg's not tilting up or falling down. It's staying nice and straight, so you shouldn't really feel much pressure on the outside of that hip, that glute area. Take a few breaths. Keep the spine long. If that is too much, you can lower the leg down and just use your toes to get your balance to support you. Leg comes down. Keep rooting forward through those fingers. And we're going to take a big breath in. On the exhale, left leg reaches back, really flexing that foot, energizing that heel back. Keep pressing through those fingers. Kind of like hollowing out the body. As we root through the top of the chest, through the shoulders, and then release. Bring that leg back down, and this time we're going to get the arms involved. So let's take a big breath in. Right leg goes back. As we exhale, navel to the spine, bring the left arm forward with the palm just facing in. Again, try and get that wrist and shoulder in a line, that ankle and hip, and lengthen through the spine. Drawing shoulder into its socket, leg into its socket, rooting down through the opposite hand, drawing in through that navel, nice and supported. If it is too much, you can always bring that hand, just gently touching it down ahead, so you're still getting that length through the arm. For two more breaths. Last breath. And release the hand down, the leg down. Take a moment, take the pressure off that right wrist if you need to, and get ready to switch sides. Nice big breath in, and off we go. Left leg reaches back. when you're ready, if you're ready. Don't feel you need to bring the arm out. If it feels too much for you, keep supporting with your hand or just have it in front of you. Reaching back, lengthening back, keep the leg into its socket, reaching forward with the arm, but keep the arm in its socket so it's not falling, it's not reaching and cramping up your neck. Keep rooting down through that supporting hand. Keep drawing in through that navel. Staying nice and lifted and long for two more breaths. And release. Bring the hand down, bring that leg down. Let's shift the weight back for a moment into a little side stretch. So left arm on the side, right arm up and over. Take a nice stretch through the side of the spine. Come back to center and other side, reaching up and over. Good. Let's come back to center and let's sit on the mat. And this time come into a bridge pose. So bringing ourselves onto our backs. Have our feet hip distance apart. Get the heels as close to you as feels comfortable. Have the pelvis in neutral. You just have a small amount of space underneath your lower back. Bring the hands to either side. And root down through your feet. Root down through your hands, keeping those knees nice and stable so they're not dropping out. We root down through the feet, through the hands. Just start feeling the pelvis lifting up as we keep rooting down. Shift the weight a little bit more into up into the shoulders. Try not to put pressure on the neck as we lift the spine up. Keep rooting down. Again, draw that navel in as you exhale. Getting that core nice and strong and awake. And then release. Start rolling down the spine as we bring ourselves all the way down. Bring the knees up towards the chest for a moment and take a little rock from side to side. And we'll come back and do another round. So again, get those heels nice and close. Rooting down, really pressing through those feet, through those hands. Shift the weight onto your shoulders. And maybe this time interlace the fingers. Keep those glutes relaxed. Maybe come up onto the toes and draw the feet slightly closer to you. If you want to take it that little bit higher. Again, check the knees aren't falling. They're staying supported. And take a few long breaths. As long as the breath is long and relaxed, you know you're in the place for yourselves. Let's go for another two more breaths. Keeping the pelvis lifted. For our final breath, keeping that core nice and active. And then we're going to release. So take the hands to the sides, walk the feet slightly forward. Coming all the way down and then bring the knees back up. A nice little rock. Well, that's spine. And let's come back to center. We'll straighten out the legs. Another nice little core. A nice little easy one for now. Hands are either side. Legs are nice and straight. If you do feel you need some support for your back, do keep one of your legs slightly bent. So we're going to start lifting the right leg so you can use the left leg for support. Take a nice big breath in. And on the exhale, just lifting that right leg up, maybe just 45 degrees to the ground. So if you're gazing down, you can probably just see the tips of your toes. And we're just holding there. So opposite leg is either bent supporting your back, or nice and straight on the floor. And then just keep that right leg up. Take a few breaths. The longer you hold it, the more it will go into your core. and then release. Bring the leg back down nice and slowly. Relax it. Get ready to switch sides. Take a nice big breath in. Exhaling, left leg just comes up slightly off the floor. Again, gazing down, you should be able to see your little toes, giving you a little wiggle of hello. If you need your right leg to support you, do go and use it. And take nice long breaths. So we're keeping the pelvis slightly tilted as we draw that navel down and draw up through the pelvic floor. Draw in those transverse abdominals. Keep rooting through your hands for support. For two more breaths. And then release. Bring that leg back down. Take a moment to relax. And now we're going to see if we can do both legs together. So slightly more challenging. Again, if you feel your back needs that help, start off with your legs bent and then take them out. If you feel you're okay and you really want to challenge that core, start tilting the pelvis slightly. Take a big breath in on the exhale as we draw up through the pelvis. Draw the navel back. Keep the chest drawing back towards the floor. Lift the legs up. Get that nice shake through the belly. And you start getting that energy to rise up to the core. Knees soften if you need that support for your back. Keep drawing in through the navel, waking up that core, keeping the body nice and long so you're not drawing it all in. Keeping it long, chest as long, spine as long. And then let's gently start lowering the legs down with control and a bend in the knee if needed. And then relax. Let the belly relax. Let the chest relax. Just a breath or so here. And we'll go for one final round. And if you want to, you can just go for having the legs bent to support your back. And if we're going to lift the chest up this time, and if that's too much, just keep the chest back down. So take a nice big breath in. As you exhale, draw up through the navel, bring the legs up, and then maybe bring the chest up as well. And you may actually find this is easier than staying all the way down. You could always take the hands to either side. And just holding there, keep the chest open, keep the neck relaxed. Keep the breath going, keep that energy rising up, getting that shape in the belly. Waking up those core, letting them know that you're here with them. Two more breaths. Final breath. And then relax, let the legs flop out. Let the shoulders relax. Let the belly relax. Let the breath relax. And then bring those knees up towards the chest. Take one knee in each hand and circle the knees. Part them together. Nice big circles. And giving the belly a little massage in the opposite direction. Giving the back a little massage too. Final circle. The knees come back to the chest. Let's straighten the legs one more time. Ending with a supine spinal twist. So take the arms to either side. Right foot, placing it on top of your left leg. Get that left arm and start taking the right knee across the body. Shift the shoulder slightly. And then as you exhale, relax the right shoulder down. Maybe turn that right palm up to help your shoulder relax back down onto the floor. That right leg can either stay on the thigh, it can come out, straighten out, go for a deeper twist, or just totally relax. So just let yourself just find the place for you, just for a few breaths in our little supine spinal twist. And then let's release. Back to center, so start shifting the neck back to center, the hips back to center, straightening out the spine, the legs. Let's get ready for the left leg. Left leg, foot on the right leg, Grab that left knee as we take it over to the right. Adjust your little shoulders and relax that left shoulder back as you exhale. Once you've settled into the twist, then decide if you want to straighten the top leg or just keep it nice and relaxed. Take a few long breaths. Just settling into that soothing twist. Good. Let's come back to center. Bring the knee, the neck back to center, and then the legs come back. Relaxing them both out. We'll take one last time, knees towards the chest. Take the arms around the legs. Take a nice big breath in. And then as we exhale, start bringing the head up towards the knees and squeeze the knees in, squeeze the legs into your abdomen. We then relax the grip on the legs as we let the head come back down to the floor. And let's do that two more times. Nice big breath in. On the exhale, start bringing the forehead up to the knees, squeeze the legs into the abdomen, release any trapped stale air. And then relax, let the head come back down, relax the grip on the legs. For our final time, nice big breath in. And then start curling up as you exhale, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. And then release, lying back down onto the mat, onto the floor. In reclining butterfly, take the soles of the feet together. Let the knees drop out to the side. Placing one hand on your belly, one hand on your heart. Let your neck be nice and relaxed. And gently closing our eyes. And we'll get ready to end our practice. And just connecting back to our breath. And in gratitude to our body. Its support as we wander through life. Tuning into that rise and fall as you inhale and exhale, letting the body gently relax. Gently let the hands go out to the side. Bring those knees back together. And then bring the knees back up. We're going to turn onto our right side or our preferred side. Unless we have high blood pressure, then do turn onto your left. To fetal position, just for a few breaths. Maybe bring the arms and the hands underneath your head. Just take a few moments here. Working nice and hard today, just creating some happy memories. And then when you're ready, let's come back up to a nice comfortable seated position. So just taking your time with your eyes soft or gently closed, whatever feels comfortable for you. Just be mindful if you do have any bright light. Come back to your comfortable seat. Bring your hands together in front of your heart. And let's have our eyes gently closed or just soft eyes as we place our thumbs in our sternum, lifting our heart up to our thumbs, connecting back to our heart as we end our practice with love, uniting our mind, our body and breath to our heart. By always thinking kind thoughts, saying kind words, doing kind deeds, and being kind to ourselves. Let's give our palms a nice brisk rub. Let's get ready to get back out there, placing those palms over our eyes and blink back into the light. Taking our hands away, and we end with love and peace and namaste. And thank you so much for joining me, and I hope to see you soon.